So there's this thing. Nothing to get worried about. Panic. You know. The end of the world. I'm fucking with you. It's not the end of the world. Well, hopefully not. But maybe you should take a seat. If you're standing, that is. Yes, take a seat. Think of a place. Somewhere important. Somewhere you feel safe. Home. Shut your eyes. Picture it. Really picture it in your mind's eye. Who is there with you?
Don't know why I'm watching this anymore. It's like reality TV. Too much reality TV. I can't seem to switch it off though. Can't stop from running the numbers through my head. Is it me, or are the walls getting closer?
What does home mean to you?
I hate questions like that.
Always feels like it's a trick.
Like I'm getting it wrong?
Like I'm the stupid one?
Everybody else looks so comfortable.
So at ease.
Did I miss some lesson at school where everyone got taught how to cope with the world?
Does someone want to go first? What does home mean to you?
Listen.
Pause for a second and listen.
The snapshots of conversation.
Small heirlooms from people's lives.
Stolen.
Someone is falling in love.
Someone is falling out of love.
Someone is falling.
Something's missing.
Lost.
What I'm saying is, I'm not some Johnny-come-lately. I didn't just hop off the train, buy myself a lovely converted house with a lovely converted loft, and then start talking about how much I love the fucking Murmurations on the pier.
Not that that's a problem. We are not here to exclude people, to shoot them down for just enjoying something.
I just want them to acknowledge that there was a before they arrived. That people exist, that they continue to exist, just beyond their line of sight.
You walk due east for 10 minutes from the city centre, keep to the light at the level, and you smile at the dubious men smoking their dubious smokes in the shadows, and they smile back. Not everything's a threat. Think of it in the dark moments.
You walk past the gentrified pubs,
the gentrified shops,
the gentrified lives.
Sometimes it makes me feel invisible, like I've just disappeared.
I like bus stops. I know that sounds weird, but there's just something about them. I spend hours looking at the maps. The journeys you can make across the city, all the coloured lines, like veins. I lose myself in it. The possibilities, the endless possibilities of where to go and who might wait for me there. The interactions, the conversations, the connections. You can go out in this town in the morning and never know where you're going to end up. All gone.
This is not the end of the world. It isn't.
It just feels like it is.
Well, it's not just gone, is it? It's not just gone. It hasn't just bloody disappeared.
Oh, no one's saying that.
That's what it sounds like.
No, it's just remember the first time. People clapping in the streets and setting up mutual aid groups for their neighbours.
Helping out food banks.
Exactly.
You know, half of Brighton would have starved if it wasn't for those people. Well, now it just doesn't feel the same. That spark, that community.
Don't say Blitz Spirit.
Why can't I say Blitz Spirit?
Because you're barely 50. The only wars you know are the ones with Matt Damon and Tom Hanks.
I do like that film.
Everyone loves that film. It's classic.
It's just that sometimes I feel that everything's just going to shit. You know what I mean?
Look, it's not raining. We've still got half a bottle left. What more is there?
Drink to that.
This place, it moves, literally. Cliffs fall, sand erodes, dog shit. Bag it up, bag it right up. Graffiti on, graffiti off. Some good, some, well, Banks isn't exactly shaking. Gotta start somewhere though. The colours, bright, like a sunrise or sunset. Your choice, hear your voice, calling from Devil's Dyke to Rotting Dean, my queen. Take my hand and walk with me through a selfie. We'll spoil it together. This is us, ours.
Oh, pop it. Don't eat my finger, don't eat it.
It's been exactly 16 months since I've touched another human being.
They never tell you how the apocalypse will affect your sex life.
Funny.
Try internet dating. Video chat?
Do I look like a teenager?
You look great for your age.
Oh, fuck off. Reception's rubbish on my phone anyway.
Absolute passion kill.
I'm lucky in the grand scheme of things. I know that. But you sit on your own in your house for so many months and you start to feel cut off from it.
What?
Life. People. The city.
Maybe when this is over, me and you, we could...
Christmas Eve. I can see your breath on the air, it's that cold. It's frost on the pebbles on the beach. For a moment, I can daydream. It's spring. Pavilion gardens. A swing band are playing. I never really dug swing. I'm more a rock and roller. But... in the daydream, everything's right, perfect. So warm, I have to roll up my trousers. Feel the grass on my legs. Open a book and drift away. Escape. The hours just fly.
Coming to first base. Heard the soup's cracking today.
And I'm back. Back here. Invisible to everybody. But those in the same situation I am. A citizen of a place that actively chosen to ignore me. A city within a city. I'm not saying I blame them, Who wants to acknowledge it? But I exist. I do. I am part of this place. It, part of me. See me.
It's a cliche, I know, but I still go to the pier and watch the Murmurations every spring, even after all these years of living here. I take some kind of comfort from those birds, that they come back, the shapes they make, together. How no matter how fast they fly, none ever seem to get left behind. We are a social animal, most are.
A fairy dress.
A stick of rock.
Some seagull shit.
Burning the clocks.
Fat boy slim.
Pinky brown.
Monson rockers tearing up the town.
Jofra Archer.
Disco Pete.
Potholes still on every street.
Caroline Lucas.
Chris Eubank too.
It's transient, this place.
Eccentric.
It's me.
It's you.
Hi, Carlos. How are you? Oh, good, thanks. How are you doing?
This place.
It moves.
Literally.
Feel it.
In my veins.
In my lungs.
My heart. Someone is lost.
Hey, come on, give us your glass.
Someone is found.
Cheers. Cheers.
This isn't the type of thing people like me do.
That's what I thought.
But
if you think like that,
then people like us would never get to do anything.
This place, it moves.
Literally.
And there's this thing about it.
Makes me feel proud.
Like I belong.
I'm seen.
Even though it's not perfect.
Even when I don't feel strong.
When it's all too much.
Like it's the end of the world.
A place.
My place.
It's still here. Still waiting for me.
Home. And that's enough.